night, acidity, reflux nightmares drive me to awaken and escape the foul net it hath cast. Escape into reflections, remembrances of moments now past. I recall that I first saw the friendly bee at the beginning of spring, the end of winter. A lonely carpenter bee that made its home in the soffit above my red rented porch. I'd be out there, smoking, sighing, writing or not, when the buzzing bee came droning by. "Hi there, friendly bee," I'd say. "May I ask, how are you today?" And though it gave no answer, I would still give it greeting from time to time when applicable. But woe, oh woe to thee, friendly bee, the moment the wasps arrived. The wasps, compounded, aggressive, violent, territorial, yellow, black, banded bastards, air assaulters, aerosaulters, aerial acrobatic, venomous stingers. They came and arrived, and in a month's time chased me off that porch from the hours between 9 a.m. to 10 p.m. Gorilla, Paleozoic throwbacks, primitive, wood-gnashing little punks with a disdainful upside-down triangular head, with their serrated jaws that haunt me, that cause such fear in my own home. All day, the wasps attack my air conditioner exhaust. I watch them occasionally during late, early afternoon poetic dreaming driftings. Their violent, mean-spirited silhouettes dart and bob and sashay away hither and yon as wasps are wont to be. Buy empty cans of poison in a great deluge of propellant. I serve them a banquet of poison, and though many died, it seemed to only encourage them further, deeper, as they made their nests harder to find until finally they were hidden from the poison. On the other side of the house, under the shingles, simply as angry as ever. And I question not their anger. I had lain waste to a swath of their kin until they began to mob the door before I'd open it. And still, while this was going on, once in a while in the morning, sometimes I'd catch sight of the friendly bee. And I'd wonder how he or she was doing, braving the gauntlet bumble in my beige brown velvet coat, bopping and hair was fluttering toward home. And then I found the scene where fate met it so unceremoniously. Friendly bee, oh, it was its exoskeletal body. The friendly bee lay constricted, dead, across from an equally dead paper wasp. Malevolent little murderer. I know the wasp was the aggressor, and with that I escaped indoors before they could get me to slam the door shut behind me. Stop, and I cannot turn it off. All morning, I was working at lunchtime, smoking until throat burning. an hour or two ago, I was setting wasp traps. Shall I thwart their advance someday? The train out the window every 5-15 minutes. It is vibrating thy house and thy brain. Highball glass. The bomb. All the liquid levels in themselves are seen from the very first Jurassic Park. Tension headaches. All the time.
Running around, I cannot stop, I cannot turn it off. Attending to all the different aspects of this strange business. Multi-tiered, multi-layered, multimedia, there are so many things to consider.
In order to get the words out there, past the wasps, the art and music out there, past the wasps. And it has been good to be able to share this propitious fruit with a few of those so trusted in thine heart. I never imagined there would be anything whatsoever to be shared in such a way. What else is there to do today except write, cook, finish the dishes?
I already get a load of laundry. It is an exceptionally beautiful day.
Too bad the wasps are still after me. I sure hope that trap works. War on the wasps. It's that time of year again, when the invaders hath returned to take over, seemingly overnight. I don't call this place Fort Vesperanium for nothing. The wasps, they are hungry for my blood, and I am hungry for battle. I hath not forgotten still what those little bastards did last year to my little friend, the friendly bee, so memorialized in poetry. My attacks on them cometh at dawn, spraying on them the bitter draft of organophosphate vitriol. Hours later, more hath returned. Beastly queens and work of harm. I draw all of my own conclusions. My love for life is true. Still it pains me. Still I must kill you. This whole porch, it be a wasteland. Where none can grow and all you know. And all of us will be suffering. Yet it seems no matter what I do, nothing can stop your advance.